What would it take to manufacture a long-lasting and repairable smartphone, but one that sources material and labor as ethically as possible? The folks at Fairphone founded their company in 2013 based on that question, and the Fairphone 6 is the most refined answer they've provided yet. As we've come to expect from Fairphone, we already have a nice selection of parts and repair manuals available for the Fairphone 6, and a commitment to provide 7 years of Android software upgrades and 8 years of security updates. And in addition to the 5-year warranty, Fairphone runs a loyalty program that rewards consumers for each repair performed and every year they continue to own their smartphone. There are trade-offs in the hardware. They've implemented USB 2 instead of USB 3 to reduce production costs, and the camera sensors perform well but won't quite measure up to flagship tier products. But if you're looking for a device that puts people and planet before profits, then this may well be it. Now, Fairphone's phones are predominantly aimed at the European market, but US customers can get their hands on one of these things through the partnership with Marina. So let's dive in and see how Fairphone made a repairable device, starting with everybody's favorite consumable component, the battery. The back cover is held in place by 2 T5 Torx screws, the only screw type used throughout. Once those are out, the cover slides away. Inside, there are 4 screws securing the battery and 1 up top securing a plastic cover. With the flex cable disconnected, the battery is free to come out. Using screws to secure the battery beats glue every single time, easy to remove and easy to replace. With a typical capacity of 17.26 watt-hours, the battery is glued to a thin strip of metal designed to be light in weight and resource consumption, while sturdy enough to protect the lithium-ion pouch from unintended impact. Once the battery is out, it's time to take a look at another commonly replaced component, the screen. The top half of the back cover is only held in place by clips now that the battery is out, so I'll remove that first. The 8 silver screws securing the screen are now fully revealed and can be removed. That frees the screen from the housing and reveals the single screw and bracket underneath the screen itself that secured the ribbon cable to the mainboard. There's no glue here, and that's one of the reasons why this phone is IP55 rated, but on the upside, this is one of the easiest screen removal processes I've ever seen. The beautiful 6.31 inch LTPO OLED display is slightly smaller than the Fairphone 5 6.46 inch display, but it has nearly double the peak brightness and a variable refresh rate from 10 to 120 Hz, enabling low power always on functionality. So there's no question that this is the superior screen. Next up, the USB-C port. Removing the speaker assembly immediately gives me access to the highly modular USB-C port, which is awesome if you ever have a failure due to mechanical wear. I've removed every major failure point from this section of the phone, but for the sake of completing the teardown, it's worth noting that the daughter board is also modular and easily replaceable. The warning label here sits on top of the coax cables running down from the mainboard, and while mainboard and daughter board replacements aren't going to be a typical repair for most, it's nice to know it's easily possible. But the front-facing camera and the twin rear-facing cameras are all immediately accessible the moment I pop their protective plastic cover off. I'm disconnecting everything in sight from the earpiece speaker, ultra-wide camera, the 50 megapixel main camera, and all the way down to the interconnect and coax cables. For those that have experienced it, camera repairs can be difficult and expensive, so being able to perform this repair at home and on a budget will have a meaningful impact on the device's longevity. And it's not just longevity. The modular and accessible design means that component upgrades are entirely possible, just like we saw on the Fairphone 3. At this point, you might be wondering what happened to that third camera bump on the back case. Well, that's not for a camera, but the time of flight sensor that needs its own window to the outside world to function correctly. With all those components out, there's nothing stopping me from removing the mainboard, so I'm going to remove it. One reason why the mainboard came away so easily is the use of pogo pins, which removes the need for more connectors and tiny screws. The downside is that the contact pads are glued to the frame. Add to that delicate ribbon cables and you have a potentially fiddly repair if you ever break the power button. And there you have it, a fully torn down Fairphone 6, which I'm pleased to report went back together and will continue to function for many more years to come. From ease of access to the battery to an extremely repair-friendly screen, USB-C port, and camera assembly, this phone is made with one stubborn mission in mind: to outlast anything else in the same product category and set an example as to what a fair product might look like, from raw resources to end product and well beyond. The Fraunhofer Institute found that keeping a Fairphone for 5 years instead of 3 cut the phone's carbon footprint by around 1/3. And the key to achieving that longevity is making available the parts, manuals, and software updates that consumers can reasonably be expected to need nearly a decade down the line. With these extremely well thought out and executed design decisions in mind, the Fairphone 6 easily earns a 10 out of 10 for repairability on iFixit's smartphone repairability scale, and we're very happy to recommend it once more.